Hello everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss how you can invalidate CloudFront cache using AWS Lambda. So now we are in the AWS console. So what you have to do is you have to search for Lambda, click on it, and you can see like I already have a Lambda for CloudFront invalidation. So let me create a function again for you. So I will come here and then I will type in test lambda for CloudFront validation. So then I will select the runtime as Python 3.9 and then keep it as it is, create function. So it will create a lambda for me. And then I will paste in the code for the invalidation, and I will provide that code in the description of the video as well, so you can use that, and it is very easy to set up. So yeah, you can see the code, the default code. I will remove that. I will paste in the code. So to explain you this code, so we have a Boto3.client code pipeline to get access of CodePipeline and CloudFront. So what is Boto 3? Boto 3 is basically a low level interface to the AWS services. Like it provides you access to AWS services, so you can perform different actions on that. So that's why we use Boto 3 client to get access of CodePipeline and CloudFront. And then you can see we create a job ID. So because we will be triggering the Lambda using code pipeline, so we create a unique job ID for that. And then after that, we create a variable for user params. In that, we add the particular code pipeline job data, all the particular variables. And then we create CloudFront invalidation. In the CloudFront invalidation, the main thing is the distribution ID. So which distribution, unique distribution we want to invalidate the cache for, and this data will be passed dynamically. So that's why we're using user params, then distribution ID. So whatever the data that is passed in distribution ID will be used here. And then we are specifying the path as well. So it can be slash static, like, and then whatever the path is. And then like similarly, like we can specify the caller reference that this job ID actually called this whole invalidation. And if it is a failure, then this code will be executed, that type job failed, and the message why the job failed. And if the job is not failed, it is successful, then the else code will be executed, that code pipeline job is successful, and this is the job ID. So this is basically the simple code. You do not need to actually understand it. You can just simply copy paste it and use it in your own pipeline. So this is basically it. Like you can add this and then you can click on deploy, and that's basically it. And then after that, what you have to do is you have to search for code pipeline. And then what you have to do is you have to select the pipeline in which you want to attach it. For instance, this pipeline. And then at the end, like when the code is built and deployed, after that, you need to add this step, because we need, whenever we have a new code deployed successfully, then we need to invalidate the cache on CloudFront so that the latest version is visible to all the users and all the customers. So after this step, what you will do is, it is like very simple, like let me click on edit and let me tell you. So you can see, like you can just simply click on add step, give the step a name, for instance cache invalidation, and like add stage, and it is telling me like it cannot be. So, and then after that in here, you can like type in like lambda, select the lambda, and then like you are good to go. So AWS lambda, it is telling me about asking about the function name. I can select the function. It is asking me about the user params. So I will pass in the user params here. And so yeah, like this is basically it. Like, let me show you the configuration here, the already working one. So yeah, like in the user params, I basically pass in the distribution ID and object path. Object path is basically slash star. That means all the files, all the folders, everything. So this is like a wildcard. Slash star means a wildcard, everything. I need to invalidate the cache of everything. So, and this is the distribution ID. So yeah, like I will also paste this user params in the description. So you can just like add in this, and like this after the website is deployed to S3, this function will be called and the cache will be invalidated. So it is like very simple. For instance, let me show you like how it works. Once the pipeline is deployed, then it will hit the, after the deployment, the CloudFront cache will be invalidated. Let me show you how you can check like if the cache is invalidated or not. Let me search for CloudFront. Okay. And I can also tell you like if you want to do it manually, how you can manually delete the cache or invalidate the cache. For instance, the Swigen front end. Yeah, invalidations. So you can see like we have a lot of invalidations. So all of them are occurring from this lambda functions. They are not like, and other than that, like if you want to invalidate yourself without lambda, you can just simply click on create validation, create invalidation, then do slash star. That means invalidate everything. Or if you want to like invalidate a specific directory, you can type in the directory name, like for instance source. You have made changes in the source, so you can type in slash source. So yeah, and then like for instance this, I will click on create invalidation and it will invalidate all the data of CloudFront like that as well. Other than that, like the other way is using lambdas, and it is very good. Like, and you pay very less using lambda, so it is like almost free. So if I show you, I'm using this lambda to invalidate cache of like 7 or 8 pipelines, and all of the like the work is like actively being done on all the 7 services. So, and let me show you the logs here. For instance, you can see like for instance 1 week or like custom like 3 months, you can see like the invalidation is going on. Like sometimes it is working, sometimes it also fails. Like we, that can be the case. You can check that from the logs. If it is failing, like then you can see like where it fails and what's the problem there. Otherwise you can use these logs as well to check like how your lambda is basically performing. And the code is same in this CloudFront cache invalidation. So this is the same code that I have pasted when I created the lambda for this tutorial. So this code will be pasted in the description. So thank you so much guys for watching the video.